You back for what is our last segment as I sit here in this wonderful home just before Thanksgiving and sitting here with these two young men who have been so gracious. And I know you guys got practice coming up and I don't want to keep you too much longer, but anyhow, I want to do a little bit more and end this thing with it being Thanksgiving tomorrow. I always like to talk about goofy things, like, you know, and being a family. I know every family has quirky things that they do during the holiday. I know you do. And I want you to come out with, you guys talked about, what are the sort of the quirky things that you do for Thanksgiving? And then we got the big one coming behind that, and that's Christmas. You have to run around in Santa hats or what does this family, what's the quirkiest thing that you guys have to do for the holidays? Let's start with Thanksgiving. Is there something quirky? You have to wear a turkey hat? What do you do? Can you think of the quirkiest, the goofiest thing you have to do?
Just games.
Games. Okay. Like, what, we're talking board games? Basketball games. Okay.
Yeah.
So how does that work? How does it, who's on whose team? Because I know that you try to hurt these guys.
Right.
But you better be careful because I've known you for about 4 or 5 years now.
That
means you get older. You don't get younger.
Right.
You didn't blow down
the
Achilles.
I just don't play as long.
Right.
I go hard.
When you tap out, you get them to tap out?
Good 7 minutes.
7 minutes. Okay, over here on the course that I saw across the street, you get after it there.
We play
that on Thanksgiving Day?
Thanksgiving.
We do it every time we're
together.
Yeah, what are the teams? How do the teams divide?
My parents have 18 grandkids. Everybody's here. It's like 35 of us that are here, like Christmas, or almost every weekend.
Will they be here till Christmas?
Right?
You're gonna have them here.
Volleyball will split into teams, seven, and there'll be like four or five.
So you're just doing more sports. I see the volleyball sitting over there. So there's just more sports?
We're an athletic family.
No doubt about it.
I love that.
That'll work that turkey off real quick.
Oh, yeah.
You got to work that. You can't let that stuff sit around. You'll be asleep the rest of the time.
All right.
So I think that's fun. You guys have been a blast to sit here and talk with. And like I said, I like to kind of get inside of the game, get outside of the game even, and talk about the things that you just do on a normal basis as a family. And I've had a real, real joy knowing you guys for quite a while, you know, and so this is a real treat for me.
Feeling is mutual.
Thank you. I appreciate that. Mm-hmm. And, you know, last week we haven't even talked about the big O yet, okay? Mm-hmm. And going to Oregon, talk to me about that process a little bit about what was it about Oregon that set every other school apart, and Oregon seemed to just really kind of be the place that you feel like is home for you?
Like my dad was saying earlier in the interview about me tearing my ACL early in the season. So it was hard. All the schools jumped off, you know, and Oregon came in hard and kept in contact with me every week, every day.
Okay.
Mainly all the whole coaching staff texted me.
Okay.
You know, see how I was doing and asking how my day went. So I felt like that was the main part of it, like loyalty from them. Yeah, so.
And genuine. They were genuine and sincere.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay. Okay, that made a difference for you.
Right.
Yeah.
Made a huge difference.
I think that's fair to say. And so that put you in a place where you felt comfortable, felt like home for you.
Yeah, exactly.
As far as Oregon is concerned. Well, that is tremendous. And I think the audience that we're addressing is really going to be helped by that because they're going through some of that process, not knowing how this kind of works. And, you know, do they have a young man that they feel like can play at a high level? And, you know, all the things that you talked about that got you there in the sense that they might be there, and here we go, okay? And so it's exciting for me to be here with you guys and see where you came from all the way from 8th grade to now, and it's going to be even more exciting to see how the next 3-4 years develop because there's more football to play.
Exactly.
Okay, big game coming up against John Bosco, and I want to wish you guys the best of luck, and it's been a pleasure to sit here with our 4-star defensive tackle Keon Ware Hudson and his soon to be a star. Mm-hmm. All right. You're going to get your stars too, Kyle.
Yeah,
okay. All right. And it's going to be fun to watch. And appreciate you guys having me here in your living room getting ready for Thanksgiving coming up. This is David Hill with HSPN Sports. We've gone inside the game, we've gone inside the living room. The dogs are done with us. And, you know, we're getting ready for Thanksgiving. So happy Thanksgiving, everybody. And we'll see you soon.